yeah, you're trying to play smart, a little more tentative. And but I thought the first one, they really pressured us on the wall, trying to make sure there wasn't getting across to Colby. And, I think we had, you know, we could do a little better job of being prepared for that because teams are going to pressure us, you know, pretty hard on that half wall. But, you know, when you're only generating 2 power plays a game, it's tough too. I mean, you know, you want to generate at least 3, 4, 5, and that's when you can get into a rhythm. But I think we got to do a good job, or even a little better job of maybe being prepared in the first one. So we're, you know, the couple of games before, I thought we did a good job of making sure that our first one we had some chances and, you know, made them, you know, it was a little scrambly and, you know, got the pucks on net. And at the end of the day, you know, for the stats-wise, it's a goals to count, but if we're creating scoring chances, that's what we want to do. I mean, if you're creating scoring chances with the guys we have, you know, they're bound to start going up.
Plus it could carry over to 5-on-5 play if you do get chances, whereas you don't want the carry over the other way. Whereas
exactly. If you go out there and you have a lazy, you know, a couple shifts where you're not creating any pressure and they're kind of taking it to you, it definitely falls over into 5-on-5. And if you go out there and you have a couple of good shifts where you get a couple of good chances, a couple of good shots, and make them scramble a little bit, it definitely gives you a little momentum going into 5-on-5.
I know coaches said you can't play defense on your own power play, something to that effect. But how do you find that balance between looking for the scoring opportunities but not giving things up?
Well, I think on the power play is a time where if you're going to take a chance, you probably can. But you got to make sure that you're not taking that chance to be the last guy back. And, you know, if you're a guy that is in a support role, you got to make sure you support above the puck like you would normally. You know, you can't cheat to hopefully get past a guy or bounced by a guy. If a puck's in danger, you got to get in the right position. I think the last few guys, we did a lot better job of that. And, you know, last night, frustrating, but at the same time, it wasn't like we gave up another 2-on-1 goal or another breakaway. You know, it was a bad bounce and a shot from out wide where for it to give him a shot, you'd rather be outside the faceoff dots. So, if you're going to give him a chance, that's one of the ones you want to give him.